So, Yirrei, welcome to our assembly this afternoon. And we extend that welcome to your parents and carers who'll be viewing this ceremony from home. I would ask you from the outset of today's proceedings that the formality of the ceremony be respected and applause given only at the times requested. To begin our ceremony today, I would ask you now to stand in silence as our official party enters the hall. Please stand. Good morning and welcome to the St. Columba's Catholic College 2021 Year 7 Awards Ceremony. This is indeed a very special event which recognises the achievements of students in Year 7 from 2021. I ask you now to remain standing and with respect listen to our national anthem, Advance Australia Fair.
Australians are led us rejoice.
Thank you, students. Please be seated. In prayer today, we show our respect and acknowledge the traditional custodians of this land, the Darug and Gundungurra nations, of their elders past and present on which this gathering takes place. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. God of heaven and earth, nurture in us a spirit of forgiveness, hope, and joy, as we strive to be channels of Christ's love and peace. Amen.
As we listen to your word, Lord, may it speak to our hearts and deepen our faith. This is a reading from the prophet Isaiah. Prepare the way of the Lord. Go up on a high mountain, joyful messenger to Zion. Shout with a loud voice, joyful messenger to Jerusalem. Shout without fear. Say to the towns of Judah, here is your God. Here is the Lord. coming with power, his arm subduing all things to him. The prize of his victory is with him. His trophies all go before him. He is like a shepherd feeding his flock, gathering lambs in his arms, holding them against his breast, and leading to the rest of their mother ewes. This is the word of the Lord.
Lord, awaken us to your presence as we open our hearts to you. In response to each petition, together we will pray, God of peace, hear our prayer. God of peace, hear our prayer. We pray for the parents, students, and staff of our school community. May we discover in ourselves your treasure and put to good use the qualities you entrust to us. Response: God of peace, hear our prayer. We pray for the people in our world who are suffering. Give us the courage to be your hands and your voice in the world. Response:
God of peace,
hear our prayer.
We pray for those who are ill in mind and body. May they feel Christ's presence and know they are loved and valued. Response: God of peace, hear our prayer. We pray for the leaders of our church, especially Pope Francis and Bishop Vincent. May they continue to call us to see the face of Christ in your people. Response: God of peace, hear our prayer.
We pray for all community elders and political leaders. May they recognise and serve the neediest within their communities. Response: God of peace, hear our prayer. Please join with me in saying our college prayer. Loving God, you share goodness with us and teach us what is right. Help us to care for all people, to act justly, love tenderly, and to walk humbly with you, our God. Saint Columba, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. It is my pleasure now to call forward Mr. Scollard, our college principal, to deliver his address. Please welcome Mr. Scollard.
We're going to have to try and make this work with my voice, because I have a couple of questions for you. I can't ask you questions from up there. It doesn't work so well. So I know it's Friday afternoon, I know it's a little bit warm, but I want to check your memories for you. Remember back on Tuesday morning, we had that beautiful whole school assembly where we welcomed our new year sevens into their new houses. And I told you, tell you a story. I read a quote for the school from a very significant character in history, fairly recent history. I wonder if anyone can remember who it was I quoted. So you guys are much better than Year 10. They had no hands up, and I think you've got more hands up than you and I had. So I'm not very called up for that. Okay. Well, that's fair. You've got your hand up. It's cool. So what's your name?
Phoenix.
Who was it? Was the first person asked by President of South Africa. Do you remember his name? Yep. Nelson Mandela, what's your name? Amish, great English. Excellent stuff, who are you? Okay. So there was a quote from Nelson Mandela, who is as Phoenix and Hamish have just told us. He was the first black African president of South Africa. After a really awful period in history during this thing called apartheid, which basically took all power away from anyone that wasn't of white skin. And Nelson Mandela had been really terribly persecuted. He'd been thrown into jail for about 21, 22 years because he stood up for those things that he believed in. But even in 22 years in jail, and having all his freedom and liberties taken away from him, he never lost sight of what the good things were and the hope and the positive stuff in the world. The quote that I read to school on Tuesday, if I read you again, and I know you've heard it once this week, but a second time is good. So Nelson Mandela said, "Our deepest fear is not that we are inadequate. Our deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure. It is our light, not our darkness, that most frightens us. We ask ourselves, who am I to be brilliant, or gorgeous, or talented, or fabulous? Actually, you are not to be. You are a child of God. Your playing small doesn't serve the world. There's nothing enlightened about shrinking so that other people won't feel insecure around you. We were born to make manifest the glory of God within us. And I think it's a really great quote for us to start our awards assembly. You should have had it turned for last year. Because those people who we're going to celebrate this afternoon, those people who are getting certificates of academic excellence, or service awards, or outstanding work around sport or the arts, they're people who understand exactly what Nelson Mandela was talking about. They know that your job and my job is actually to find that thing within us, that gift which God gives us, and to do the very best that we possibly can with it. Second test for this afternoon. Back when I met you guys on, I think, your first day here at school, and I think you were up in the presentation space, I told you something about year eight. Can anyone remember what it was? Cindy, what did I tell you? Excellent. So thanks for listening back then, Cindy. Great work. So I told you that all the research says that actually year eight is the most important year in high school in terms of determining your future successes both at school and even beyond school. And at the end of this year, I'll pretty much be able to have a look at those students who are getting awards, and we'll be able to make some pretty good predictions about where you'll end up, not only in 4 and 5 years' time, but even in 20 years' time. So today's twofold for me. Number one is, we want to applaud and celebrate those great students in your U group who have really taken their God-given gifts and done good things with them. We want to celebrate them and acknowledge that they did things well, they got it right. But it's also a little challenge for you and me as well. Because as we start this new year together, 2022, there is no reason why anyone in this room can't be up here getting an award in turn 4 when we have our year 8 awards assembly. Maybe you're like me, I would never have got an award for getting a whole heap of A's in my school reports. Okay? Not that I'm not smart, but I'm not that sort of smart. Okay? But there are other awards I could have got at school or would have got at school. Maybe around contributing to the community service side of school, maybe about work in the arts. I would never have got sports awards, but it's a good thing that there are people in this room who will get sports awards. Because we need all those different gifts together, you're right. So two things. We want to celebrate people who've done great things in year 7, but maybe a little challenge as you go home for the weekend as well. Which award are you going to aspire to get turn 4 this year when we have our year 8 awards assembly? Because there's no one in here who's not capable of getting an award of some sort. And if we get it right in year 8, the next 4 years are a race. So thanks for listening this afternoon. Really impressed with Phoenix and Hamish, got the names right back there, yep. And Cindy, thanks for listening. That's great. Hang on to those few things. Great quotes to remember, and don't forget how important year 8 is. Thank you.
And thank you, Mr. Scholar. I'd now like to invite Mr. Jack Brogan, the Leader of Wellbeing for Year 7 in 2021, to assist with the presentation of our College Silver Awards. So students seeking a Silver Award must have attained a minimum of 5 Bronze Awards. They must set and achieve goals related to academic achievement and college community service over a minimum period of 10 weeks. It's my great pleasure to announce the following students as having attained their College Silver Award in 2021. Zane Alderton. Zara Orney. Ruby Hammond. Alexander Kirkham. Luciana Malik, Samuel Moore, Archer Spruill, so would you please join with me in acknowledging and congratulating our Silver Award recipients.
I would now like to call upon again Mr. Brogan and Mr. Scollard to present the Year 7 Academic Achievement Awards for Semester 1 or 2.
Good afternoon, everyone. It is my pleasure to recognise the following students who have attained an Academic Achievement Award for Semester 2 in 2021. These students attained 4 or more A's in their Semester 1 or 2 report. Timothy Baldwin. In her absence, we'll also congratulate Penelope Edmonds, Ruby Hammond, Charlotte James, Eloise Kuma Dubai, Darcy Lonsdale, Luciana Malik, Samuel Moore, Archer Sproul, Paris Tarosi, Sophie Wadey, Bridget West, and Olivia Zuza. Please put your hands together for these students.
Congratulations. I'll just ask Mr. Brogan to also to stay here to present the Academic Excellence Awards. Academic Excellence Awards and medallions are presented to students who have attained 4 or more A's in both Semester 1 and Semester 2 in 2021. This is an outstanding academic achievement. So I'll hand back to Mr. Brogan to present the Year 7 2021 Academic Excellence Awards.
It is my pleasure to recognise the following students who have attained an Academic Excellence Award in Year 7 for 2021. Zane Alderton. Annalise Blattman. Amelia Crouch. Rowan Glynn. Neve Grady. Alexander Kirkham. And Nicholas Selby. Please put your hands, you seven. Thank you.
The Sporting Blue Award is the premier award for students who represent the college through selection into a state or national team as a result competing at New South Wales Combined Catholic Colleges level. This award is also presented to the students who represent a sport at a state or national level without being part of the New South Wales Triple C. This award acknowledges exceptional talent and commitment to sport. The student who has received a College Sporting Blue Award for State Athletics is Michael Gardner. Please put your hands together for Michael. Congratulations, Michael.
So, staff and students, that concludes our Year 7 Academic Awards Ceremony for 2021. On behalf of Mr. Scollard, the college staff, and your parents and families who could not be present with you today, I'd like to congratulate you all on your outstanding achievements throughout what has been a challenging couple of years. So I'd like to thank Mr. Scollard, our flag bearers, all the staff who have made this ceremony possible. And I'd conclude today's ceremony by please standing and listening to our college song. All right, so please stand silently while our flag bearers lead our procession from the hall.
All right, guys, the music's not going to play, so let's go. Australia first. Okay, guys.